The future better get ready for me. Cause I'm Foxy Cleopatra, and I'm a whole lot of woman.
Hi, my name is Nacho, welcome back to the channel. And yes, that title is clickbait, because I wasn't born with only two brain cells constantly fighting each other for third. I know Cleopatra wasn't black, given the vast amount of proof and research done to probably one of the most interesting women in the history of not only Egypt, but potentially the world. But in true Netflix fashion, and it's funny that I found out about this just after my latest video about redheads being race swapped constantly with black people, they are making a docu-series. It's like a series, but serious. Where one of the most iconic lines in the whole trailer is this.
My grandmother saying to me, I don't care what they tell you in school, Cleopatra was black.
Sorry. I'm just gonna play that one more time.
Cleopatra was black.
She was black! Fuck what Miss Frizzle told you in third period history class. She was black! My girl Clay was as dark as the night sky. That girl ran with the brothers, Julius Caesar and my boy Mark Anthony. Her actual name was Cleopatra. Who can forget the famous twerk on them haters' stone sculpture after her victory on the Battle of the Nile?
For shizzle my nizzle.
Okay, I'll stop. Let me just segue into the serious part of the video with this picture of the actual Cleopatra eye-rolling the Netflix suits. Now, Cleopatra the Seventh Philopatra was not black. The same way, Woman King is not a movie about a brave group of female warriors defending their lands from foreign slave traders. Oh no! They were the slave traders, and the French came to stop them. On top of that, they didn't defend shit. They got absolutely decimated because the French had guns and only lost like 3 men against the countless losses that Dahomey suffered. And I'm pretty sure by losing they mean those 3 dudes went out for a piss mid-battle and got lost on their way back. But the movie casually forgets to mention this. This is as dumb as that one time people were angry at Rami Malek because he wasn't dark enough to play the Pharaoh in Night at the Museum 3, when he is literally Egyptian. But that's not what I'm angry about, because anyone with a sheet of paper thick worth of forehead will know the real story. Now, I'm angry because these cunts are making me study Egyptology to get the facts to make this video. So please like and subscribe. So let's summarize the actual story of our girl Cleo.
This is serious.
Cleopatra, the seventh of her name, is the descendant of Ptolemy I, one of the generals of Alexander the Great, that was given the territory of Egypt after the mysterious death of his liege. After the death of her father, Ptolemy XII, Cleo and his brother Ptolemy XIII were appointed rulers of the land, but that didn't vibe with a much older, more ambitious Cleo, who started to make the decisions by herself. This, of course, also didn't suit well with his brother and advisors, who plotted against her and had her exiled. With the help of Julius Caesar, who she seduced in probably the riskiest and most important decision of her life, and after his brother made some questionable decisions, she was able to reclaim the throne of Egypt for herself, after defeating her younger brother in the Battle of the Nile and having her younger brother Ptolemy XIV killed, she finally solidified herself as the only queen of Egypt. The history books describe Cleo as a ruthless yet very smart ruler. She spoke 7 languages, including Egyptian, the first of her Greek family capable of doing so without an interpreter, which greatly added to her political life with the other Egyptian aristocrats. She was schooled and proficient in many skills, such as oratory, and was able to seduce 2 of the most powerful men in the history of Rome, yet this doesn't take away from her personal successes. She was not described, however, as the most beautiful woman in the world, and even sculptures and paintings that show some of her features are not consistent with one another, but it is said that being in her presence was captivating and charming, despite her beauty not being incomparable. She finally died by committing suicide after the death of Mark Antony and was the last queen of the country before it was absorbed by the Roman Empire. I could dig a little deeper, but for the purpose of this video, those are the basic facts that you should know about her. And I probably also shouldn't tell you this because of the woke feminists that are set to take down the patriarchy with her as an inspiration of female empowerment, that the name Cleopatra in Greek means glory of her father.
That's awkward.
Now that the basic facts are laid down, we can look at the trailer.
There was a time long ago when women ruled with unparalleled power.
Wrong. She ruled with unparalleled power because Caesar helped her achieve that position after defeating her brother, much like Mark Antony did later. Same as many other women who assume queenship usually after the husband's death and before their son's ascension, such as Nefertiti, Olympias, and Artemisia. Carry on.
I would die for Egypt. What would you die for?
She would have never picked a sword against a trained soldier. She was 5 foot tall.
I am Isis. I am a god.
Whether or not she referred herself as a goddess, it is true that she was compared with the like of Isis and sometimes the Greek goddess Aphrodite, with Caesar even raising a statue of her in the Temple of Venus, which didn't really suit well with the Romans. Now, in this particular case, her saying, I am a god, feels more like a yes, queen, oh my goddess, slay, type of commentary. This is what they're getting wrong. She became known through history because of her amazing life, not by dyeing her hair blue and putting she them in her bio.
As long as she's alive, she is the pharaoh.
My father's will names me co-ruler of Egypt.
Julius Caesar is aware that Cleopatra is one of the best educated women in the Mediterranean.
He wants to be king to Cleopatra's queen.
There is no future without the past.
And here you are trying to change the past.
She was using these relationships with Mark Antony to protect herself and her country.
There is no Rome without Egypt.
There was. And Rome eventually took over Egypt. Read a book.
Cleopatra was trying to save the country that she loved from destruction.
I did what I had to do to protect what is mine.
This is a woman exercising power.
Cleopatra was a Ptolemaic ruler. The very first Ptolemy is a general of Alexander the Great.
It's possible that she was an Egyptian.
I imagine her to have curly hair like me and a similar skin color.
It was not possible, and you have a very vivid imagination.
I remember my grandmother saying to me, I don't care what they tell you in school, Cleopatra was black.
I hate to say this, but your grandmother was dumb, and you should feel bad about it. She was of Greek descent, as I explained before. This is what a Greek person looks like, and this is what a Greek person used to look like. So where would the black genes come from if Greece is clearly not in Africa? On top of that, it is well known that royal family members used to fuck each other to preserve the purity of their lineage, which didn't work so well for Tutankhamun, but that's a topic for a different channel. So there wouldn't be any black genes anywhere near her system. I don't want to pull out the book of genetics for dummies, but I will if a single one of the comments tries to correct me on this. And if you think I'm being too harsh, you should check how the Egyptians were on their African slaves. Oh yeah, the Africans were enslaved by Egypt. But I'm pretty sure that's not gonna be included in the docuseries.
She has become an icon.
I am a god.
That's the second time you've said that.
Queen of kings!
Her story resonates with every woman.
Wow, I actually feel dumber just by watching that. And as expected, all news sources that weren't dropped the fat stack of inclusivity money from Netflix are talking about the backlash, or in this particular case, blacklash, that this series is receiving from, well, everybody. I have to say, this is kind of refreshing. People actually made a change.org form to cancel the show that was getting a lot of traction, and change.org pulled it down. I guess we know where some of that inclusivity money went to, huh? If this was a comic book character or a book character, sure. You can take the liberty to race swap as many of them as you want. It's your money anyways. But you are attempting to rewrite history. Stop complaining about whitewashing in Hollywood when you are trying to blackwash history. Written, solid data. There are museum wings dedicated to this woman that you're trying to use as a vehicle for your dumbass message of empowerment and inclusivity. Who greenlighted this? What the fuck were they thinking? Did I mention they're getting sued over this too? And the best part of everything, do you know who is behind this marvelous example on how to out yourself as a complete goddamn idiot? Drum rolls, please.
No, 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 no. Ah, look at the top of his head.
G.I. fucking Jane, the Oscars so white cheating bitch, who sat down and interviewed her cuckold husband, the former beloved actor who became the butt of the joke of the latest, very successful Chris Rock Netflix special, after she made him slap him on stage right before winning an Oscar. You can't fucking make this up. I couldn't fucking believe it writing the script. Wonderful, Jada. Top-notch quality content you're providing right here. My Girl Clay Clay will premiere on Netflix on May the 10th. Unless someone brightens up before that and cancels it, it's a 4-episode series that I couldn't find how much it cost, but I really hope she paid out of pocket so she feels the fucking losses. But if you watched this far into the video, leave us a like, hope you had as much fun watching as I had making this. Let me know in the comments down below which is your favorite docu-series that is not complete and utter made-up fantasy straight from the mind of a delusional woman. And as always, I've been Nacho, hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.